In a previous tutorial, we showed you how to use the optimization tool to run multiple simulations to monitor their effect on output parameters of those simulations. While this is a powerful tool, there is another tool that allows you to do the same thing, but with a wider range of input and output parameters. This advanced feature is called the batch simulation. In this tutorial, we will show you how to use the batch simulations and what they can be used for. Here you can see the options that are available for the optimization tool. Batch mode can do the same thing, but with a much wider set of input and output parameters. Here is the list of output and input parameters for batch simulations. As you can see, there is a much wider range of options for input and output parameters here. The basic procedure when running a batch simulation in PVsyst is shown in this diagram. From within PVsyst, we first choose the simulation parameters that are going to be changed in the batch run, as well as the result variables that should be present in the output file. From this, PVsyst will create a batch parameter file in CSV format that contains the definition for a single simulation. The user then needs to edit this file, adding a line for each simulation that should be run. The complete parameter file is then fed back into PVsyst. PVsyst will then execute all the specified simulations. After the batch simulation is complete, PVsyst will generate a second CSV file that contains the simulation results. Now let's demonstrate how to use batch simulations. First, let's give a new variant to the residential demo project. Open the project and open VC0. Save a new variant. We will call the variant Sheds Batch Mode. Change the orientation to unlimited sheds. Instead of running the simulation, click on Advanced Simulation. Click on Batch Simulation. The first tab in the Batch Simulation dialog concerns the CSV files for the simulation input parameters and the simulation results. If no batch runs have been performed so far for this project, there will not be the option to use an existing parameter file. The CSV files will be stored in the User Batch folder in the workspace. You can edit the column separator here. By default, it will use the international settings that are used in Windows, but if you want to use a different separator, you can select it from this drop-down box. We now need to define the input parameters and the result variables. The input parameters are defined in the Simulation Parameters tab. There are four sub-tabs here to choose your simulation parameters. The first tab concerns the weather parameters and how the results will be saved. In this tutorial, we will leave these advanced parameters at their default values. The next three tabs allow you to choose different variables that you want to vary between the different simulations. In our case, we will use the plane orientation parameters, plane tilt, and pitch. We will also use the number of modules in series in the system parameter tab. There are also various loss parameters you can choose from, but we will not use those in this example. Next, we need to choose the results that we want to export from each simulation. Click on the Results Variables Specification tab. You can select any number of parameters here. In this example, we will look at globe inc, which is the global incident irradiance on the collector plane. It is located under inc col. We will also look at e-grid under system. This represents the energy injected into the grid. Finally, let's look at array on under array to show the duration of the PV production of the array. Once you have selected your output parameters, you can move them around using the field on the right with the mouse. This will define the order in which the columns with the simulation results will be written to the output file. Make sure that Activate Batch Mode for the next simulation is selected, and click OK. A dialog will pop up informing you that a new CSV file has been prepared. Click OK. Now you will see the batch mode appear at the bottom of the dialog. Before we can run the batch mode, we have to prepare the CSV batch parameter file with our simulations. Click on Open in the Explorer to open the CSV you have just created. You can use any spreadsheet software, or even a text editor, to modify the CSV file. The first 10 rows give various information about the simulation run and the batch mode. You do not need to modify any of these lines. Row 20 gives you a reminder that you have to close the file before executing the simulation. This has to be done so that PVsyst can open the file. You can delete this line. On line 16, you will see the first simulation. The first column is the identifier of the simulation. You will notice that it starts with sim and an underscore. Each simulation that you want to run in PVsyst needs to start with sim and an underscore. The next columns show the input parameters. Finally, there is a column for a simulation comment. You can put whatever you would like in this field. It will not impact the simulation. All other variables for the simulation will be based on the variant that you started with for the batch simulation. To create more simulations, you need to first add identifiers. Then you need to define your input parameters. Note you can leave some values blank. If you leave parameters as blank, PVsyst will use the values from the variant. Once you have set all your batch parameters, save the CSV and close the window. Return to PVsyst and click the play button to run the simulation. PVsyst will warn you if you really want to perform the batch simulation. Click Yes. The simulations will start, and you will see a double bar reflecting the progress of the simulations. When the simulations finish, click OK. Go back to the User Batch folder in your workspace. There is now a second CSV file with the text batch results in the file name. Open that file. The CSV has the same parameters as the first spreadsheet. All blanks in the input parameters have been filled in with the default values from the variant. Next, there is a column called Error. This column will show error and warning messages, if any, that happened when initializing and running the simulation. If there is a fatal error in a simulation, this line will have no results. Next, there are columns for all the output parameters and their results. This is the main output of a simple batch simulation. In this video, we demonstrated how to use the batch simulation tool in PVsyst. This powerful tool can help you make design decisions by monitoring key simulation results as a function of almost any input parameter to the simulation.